Hi, I'm Rob Pelc, founder of woodslabs.com, your source for epoxy, wood slabs, colorants, hairpin legs, table bases, wood finishes, and more. Today we're talking about epoxy, mostly deep pour epoxy, and how do you color that epoxy? There's a lot of questions we get from customers and we get online of how do I get the swirls and the metallic sparkle versus how do I get transparent epoxy? There's a few different ways to do that. We're going to talk about the differences and the choices of colorants today for epoxy. So when we're filling big voids, knots, making river tables here at woodslabs.com, our go-to epoxy for the big knots, big voids, and those river tables is the Wise Bond Deep Pour Epoxy. It's a 2-to-1 ratio of resin to hardener, and we can pour this really thick, up to about 2.5 inches thick, all in one go. And that gives you some of those big cool swirls that you see in some of the river tables. It also, if you pour it clear, it has really good clarity, it has good bonding strength. It routes and sands nicely. So that's the Wise Bond Deep Pour. It's a 2-to-1. We do sell it on our woodslabs.com website. We use it in our classes when we give epoxy classes here, and we pour it just about every day. So it's time tested in our production environment and a lot of customers throughout the US. Okay, so in your epoxy deep pour, don't be cheap. You're basically gonna get what you pay for. So like I said, we recommend up and down the Wise Bond Deep Pour. And one of the main reasons is the clarity. This is a non-yellowing epoxy, has a lot of UV resistance in it, and you get really good clarity with this. Now, if you're new to doing epoxy, we don't recommend you go out and you pour clear your first time on your first project, because there are some considerations to be made for reducing the bubbles that can come off the wood or off the object. I know the guys are screwing around, putting some pizza. One of the guys' lunch got trapped in epoxy, and looks like they stole his dessert. They took an orange, put it in the epoxy. So just a funny example, you can cast anything in epoxy, okay? But if you're gonna do the clear casting or even the tinted casting that's tinted orange, don't make it your first project. The mica powder is the easiest one to start off with, but this is one epoxy you can choose that will give you a good all around use for no matter what dye or what clarity you're looking for. Okay, so one of the most commonly used colorants for epoxy is mica powder. So mica is a natural stone that yields when you crush it up and grind it up, that shimmery different colors. And it's available in a powder form. These are 5 gram. We also do 15 grams and a larger 50 grams. And it comes in a rainbow of colors. So this is something, if you like that metallic sparkle, you want to choose from a rainbow of different colors. You want to see those big swirls in the epoxy. It's not all one solid color. It's got a lot of swirls and that metallic shimmer to it. Then mica powder is the way to go. People ask a lot of times, how much mica powder do I use? Good rule of thumb is about 5 grams, which is these small bags here, per kit. And most of the epoxy we sell in a 1.5 gallon kit. So you're going to use 5 grams for a 1.5 gallon kit. Not to say some people use less, some people use more. But it's a good idea when you have it in the bucket and you're mixing it up, it's in that dark bucket, you really can't see what that looks like. Take a plastic cup and lift it up, hold it up to the light and see. But usually somewhere around 5 grams will be that sweet spot for what you're gonna need for the mica powder. So a little bit goes a long way. Also, people talk online about all these different things, putting spray paint in their epoxy, this and that. Remember, whatever you add to epoxy will technically weaken it. So these are true tested colorants for epoxy. They're made for dumping into epoxy and coloring epoxy. And as long as you don't go more than 5% of a colorant, you're not gonna weaken it too much where you're gonna notice. But there are some things that will react with epoxy. So the colorants are really the cheap thing of the equation. So I wouldn't skimp on the colorants here, because it's really the cheapest part of the whole project you're gonna do is your epoxy colorant. So buy something that's made for epoxy. Like I said, these are mica powders, whole rainbow of colors. You're gonna get a bunch of swirls. We have a walnut table over here that we did show for our showroom. You're gonna see some of these swirls here. Now, every time you pour it, you're gonna get different swirl patterns. It's caused from the exothermic reaction when that chemical reaction kicks off and those molecules of that polymer start to bind, they create heat. The more you pour at once as far as thickness, the more heat, the more big swirls. So the Wise Bond, you can pour 2, 2.5 inches thick, you'll get more heat, and that epoxy can handle it, and it'll give you bigger swirls. So as you can see with this walnut table, the mica powder is a little bit dulled down, and that's from the Rubio Monaco oil that was over it. And any oil finish is really gonna dull down your mica powder. So you wanna sand that to a higher grit, to try to shine through some of that mica. Now, if you really want to show off that mica, you can try going over it with a clear coat, something more like this bar and tabletop epoxy. That's the Wisebond bar and tabletop. And you can also see that you get a little bit more shimmer out of that mica powder when it doesn't have an oil finish on top of it. So if you want to take your mica powder colorants to the next level, then you're going to want to try out the Y-Shift color shifting pigments. This is what you're going to get when you move back and forth. You're going to see different colors and shades shimmer through that. Kind of like when you see those fancy cars on the street and they're different colors from different angles. And you're going to get different effects based on how much of this powder you put into your mix. So we have another example that's done with a little bit less colorant ratio than that. You can see it's almost see-through and it's kind of wispy clouds that change color. Bob Ross would really like these little wispy clouds. So don't be afraid to play around with different amounts of colorant in your epoxy, because here, this is one instance where less of the colorant actually looks pretty cool. But for some projects, putting more in is gonna look nice as well. So this is one where sometimes less is best of this colorant. So if you want a solid color, this is no swirls, no metallic shimmer like the mica powders. This is just solid primary colors, which you can mix with your little color wheel chart there, figure out what color you want. But this is solid colors in your opaque liquid dyes. But this is when you don't want any metallic shimmer. You don't want any swirls to the epoxy. You just want a solid color. Let the wood show off its grain. The epoxy's just there, standing around on the side. So this is solid color epoxy dye. Okay, so another option we have for colorants is the glow in the dark. And these are really cool, but they are made from highly radioactive material. So make sure you suit up before you go using these. No, just kidding. They're totally safe as long as you don't eat them. But one thing to seriously keep in note about these is you'll see on some of the packages, it's one color when it's cured in the daytime and it's going to glow a different color at night. So don't just assume that the white powder is going to glow white. This white powder actually glows blue at nighttime, and that's what it looks like cured. So this is one instance where the cured powder looks different than the unmixed powder, looks different than the nighttime look. So make sure you read the packages and the descriptions online real close about these, about what color the powder is in the dry form versus the mixed form versus the nighttime mode. One thing that people ask us about glow-in-the-dark powders is how long will they last? There's no real clear-cut scientific data on how to calculate that, how much UV exposure, how much they recharge, uncharge, how long that glow-in-the-dark will glow. Nothing guaranteed on that, but while they are glowing, could be several years, a couple decades, who knows, but they do look pretty cool. So again, glow in the dark, and you have a bunch of different color options for that. So alcohol inks are another way to color your epoxy. That's if you want that kind of see-through, sea-glass look. And it comes in a bunch of variety of different colors as well. And these make really cool tables out of these. But again, we don't recommend this for your first attempt because you will be fighting some bubbles coming off the wood. You need to coat that with a quick coat on the edges first. But this is actually all the same color alcohol dye here. So this was 5 drops in this little cube of 3.5 ounces. This one here was 10 drops. And this darker one here was 20 drops. So as you add more of the alcohol dye, you're gonna change the intensity of that color. Like I said, don't use it for your first project, but after you play with the mica, I'd move on to these. So check out woodslabs.com. You can get glues, you can get Odie's oil, you can get Rubio Monaco interior oils, exterior oils, West Systems Boat Builder Epoxy we use for filling little cracks and splits. The Wisebond bar and tabletop, that's if you want that big shimmery tabletop bar top. The Quick Seal, Wisebond Deep Pour, wood slabs, giant slabs, little slabs, big slabs, end grain slabs. Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We have a lot of tips and tricks to show you guys. Now go build something.